Yo, what is going on, guys? Your friend host here, ConnorXcrash, and this is the Nintendo Switch OLED Tears of the Kingdom Edition. For the past few days, I've been using this as my primary Nintendo Switch, and I must say that this is a must for any diehard Zelda fan. So in this video, I'll be showing bits of my unboxing recording where I give my first impressions, opening it for the first time, and then giving my general overall thoughts on this edition of the Nintendo Switch OLED. So if you guys want to see even more content like this, you guys want to see me blow more of my money on awesome, cool stuff like this, make sure you guys leave a like and subscribe if you guys want to see even more Nintendo and Sonic the Hedgehog content. And with that being said, let's just dive straight in. So to start things off, let's take a look at some of the unboxing I did on the day that I got the console. So with that being said, let's go back in time. No more. Let's just open this up. Except you guys are going to be the first to see this. You guys are going to be the very first ones to see this before me. Alright, let's see how this looks. This looks absolutely incredible. This looks awesome. So first off, let's go ahead and take out the console, because I'm going to obviously want to look at that first. So the console itself, let's move this box out of the way. Oh, I love the design on the back. The design looks so cool in the back. You can't really see on the camera. Honestly, yo, that design. I love the detail. Even though it's not really much, I do like it. I do love it. Alright, let's take this out. Oh my gosh, dude. Okay, there we go. Okay, cool. Got it out. Dude, that is sleek. Let's see how the stand opens up. Let's try this. Whoa. Okay, this is so weird. Because compared to this, and comparing it to this, this stand is such a huge improvement. I love this. I love everything about this stand. Onto the Joy-Cons. That is so sleek, and you cannot deny it. That looks so freaking sleek. Like, oh my gosh. And then on the back, you got, like, these symbols as well. Like, I feel like these are symbols that are going to be an occurring theme throughout the game as well when you walk around the Hyrule as well. I haven't seen any in the trailers, though. I forgot to bring my mic back over here. Yo, this actually looks pretty sleek. I love the cybernetic design on the left one, and then, like, just the cloud. Like the cloud aesthetic on the right Joy-Con. Like, I just love the contrast between the two. It just looks so cool. And the symbol at the bottom. Love the Joy-Cons. Like, honestly, this is probably the best looking limited edition Switch that we've gotten. Another HDMI cable. Very handy. Always gonna need one of those. AC adapter. A USB-C adapter. Then we got ourselves, the Joy-Con straps. Oh yeah, I forgot about these. It's like gold braided straps as well. Like, dude, that looks so sleek. Dude, with the white, oh my gosh, that looks so good. That looks so, so good. I gotta say this. I have to make a comment about this. I have a mess back here. I know. I'm sorry. It's just packaging from Amazon. Why not anything for this? Like, just why? Like, we just do something for this. Like, honestly, why can't they do something special for this guy? This guy gets no special treatment. It's just always black, 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 black. That's not true. They actually did a special Mario Red and Blue edition, and they actually had the Joy-Con grip actually be blue to symbolize Mario's pants. So I guess I was wrong. And then the dock. Now you guys will be the first ones to see this. All right, the back right now, I like the aesthetics on the back. And then let's look at the front now for me. Oh my gosh, this looks absolutely dope. I love this. This looks awesome. And yeah, that's basically it. That's basically all that came with the box. With that being said, I'm going to take this to the living room. All right, so let's go ahead and turn on the Switch for the first time. Hope it has some charge. Oh boy, here we go. Here we go, boys. Here we go. Ooh, that display looks so nice. Oh my gosh. You guys can't see it on the camera, but this display looks so much better than the original Switch screen. Oh my gosh. As you can tell, I was very impressed with my first hands-on experience with the Nintendo Switch OLED, especially this edition of the console, although I feel I gave it too much credit and appreciation for its design, specifically the paint job. Don't get me wrong, this is the nicest looking Nintendo Switch we've had so far, but I feel like Nintendo could have done more. For example, let's start with the console. It is using the basic stock black shell that we're used to on Nintendo Switch consoles, with a subtle engravement on the back. This engravement is the same cloud swirl pattern that we've been continuously seeing across the board from trailers and advertisements for Tears of the Kingdom. It is a nice touch,
but I feel like they could have colored the pattern with either gold or white to make it stand out more, or at least look more appealing. Besides that, the console itself is a standard Nintendo Switch OLED shell with nothing else to get excited about. However, the Joy-Cons and dock say otherwise. The Joy-Cons are what, in my opinion, really make this limited edition stand out. The base paint job has a gold metallic look to give off the illusion of it being gold, along with the speckles that give off that shiny finish as well. Each Joy-Con has a different pattern on it that symbolizes a different aspect of the game. The right Joy-Con continues that cloud swirl pattern that we have been seeing so far, being painted white this time and overlapping the bottom of the Joy-Con. On the left Joy-Con, it has this cybernetic green pattern that I'm assuming represents Link's infected arm from the game. Then, at the bottom of both Joy-Cons, we see a strange logo that I cannot identify for sure, and I'm assuming that it's the weird character that appeared during the final trailer of the game, but who knows, it's just speculation. If we flip both Joy-Cons over, we see two interesting icons at the bottom of the bold white paint job on the back. I cannot identify these symbols either, but I do have a theory. Earlier this year at PAX East, Nintendo advertised The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom with a giant statue of Link. If you were to look closely at his arm, you can see that some symbols appear across his arm, and they look very similar to the ones that appear on these Joy-Cons. Either way, I could be wrong, but it's a nice attention to detail for fans like myself. Let's move on to what proudly could sit next to your TV while gaming, the dock. This dock looks amazing. The small details and artwork that are displayed on the front make it stand out in any space that it sits in. Taking a closer look at the art, we notice a Triforce along with the golden goddesses sitting in each segment of the Triforce. The Triforce also sits in its Hylene crest in the center as well. Then on the right side of the dock, we see that continued cloud swirl pattern, but instead painted with gold. And on the left side, we see that cybernetic pattern again, kind of like an inscription, but this time also painted in gold as well. And if you were to look really closely on the dock, you can see these grayish-white, subtle, zone-eyed dragons that surround the Hylian crest. Really love that extra attention to detail, and just the whole package itself, the whole entire artistic visuals on the front of the dock really just make it a really glorious art piece to have for gamers. The last thing that has a special design is the Joy-Con rails. Simply put, the rails have the same bold white paint that exists on the back of the Joy-Cons. As for the strap, it has a nice gold braided look to it, with white indents sparring across it as well. The buttons remain in their default black, unfortunately, but it's not like anyone uses these anyways, so yeah, I'm sorry, nobody cares. Overall, considering this may be the last Nintendo Switch limited edition we'll receive from Nintendo, this is a well-designed work of art for Zelda fans, and I'm glad that Nintendo had this planned before heading into their next console. I'm grateful that I was able to get my hands on an OLED Switch, especially this one. After playing on the OLED for a couple of days now, there are a variety of things that I enjoy about it, mainly when using it in handheld mode. Having a bigger screen with not only colors that pop out, but also more accurate blacks and whites on the screen is much appreciated for someone like me who plays it a lot at night in handheld mode. The only thing I'll have to worry about is not ruining the matte finish of the console like I did with my previous Nintendo Switch. Apps in the comments for me. Again, I really enjoyed unboxing this and reviewing this, and I can't wait to play Tears of the Kingdom May 12th on this Nintendo Switch when it releases. And I will be streaming my playthrough of Tears of the Kingdom on the channel as well. So if you want not miss out on that, make sure you are subscribed with notifications so you don't miss out when I go live for that. I will also be streaming later today playing the Splatoon 3 Zelda Splatfest with Cookie, my friend Cookie on Discord. And if you guys want to see me play that in my Champion's Tunic costume, make sure you guys tune in on here on YouTube or on my Twitch channel. Really appreciate it if you follow me over there as well. And again, yeah, that's pretty much it. So thank you guys so much for stopping by and watching the video. If you guys did enjoy this and you liked a little something, make sure you leave that like. And if you guys want to see even more content from either Nintendo or Sonic content that I make, make sure you do subscribe as well with notifications so you don't miss out on when I go live or upload a video. And if you want to join my community as well, you can join my Discord server as well in the top right corner. So that's pretty much it. With that being said, I'm going to go ahead and just play some Breath of the Wild on the Switch for now, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next one. Peace out.